lot of you are thinking about which tools to use when developing C++ GUI apps. And if you watched my video about why you shouldn't choose C++ as your first choice when developing GUIs, well, you're already frustrated. So let me guide you through a straightforward guideline so that you won't get lost in the sea of choices and get influenced by weird opinions from weird people like me. After watching this video, you will be able to look at each toolkit and choose what best suits you. However, I will present my preferences along the way to guide you to a clear path if you can't really think of something that might suit you. And by the way, I want to clarify this as much as I can. I'm not going to bore you with all the technical details since I am assuming you are a beginner to this subject. I know you don't know much about graphics rendering and all that crazy stuff, because if you did, you wouldn't have to watch this video. You can figure it out by yourself. So don't go all crazy in the comment section blaming innocent me for not using technical words, because I know how to say it all in simple terms. Now, I want to start with the one I've been teaching in my channel for a long time now. This is because it is one of the most popular ones out there for beginners. Nice. However, you can still use it to make professional apps as well. It's WinForms.
Ooh, that old deprecated technology. Is that what you're talking about? Meow, meow, meow.
I know, right? Well, you know, the thing is, I might have a little relationship with it, and don't you dare try to destroy it. So, WinForms, right? What's the deal with it? Well, WinForms is one of the fastest and easiest ways to get into C++ GUI programming. You can design UIs with the visual designer, and all you have to worry about is the logic behind the code. However, you can't really use it to build fancy, modern, fluent UIs with fancy animations and all of that. Well, if you really try, you can, but I'm talking about the easiness. But the point is, it does the job for someone who is getting into the colorful GUI world from the black and white console world. And even since Microsoft allows some sort of a doorway to the C# .NET framework, you get all the power from the .NET framework and its cool libraries like the drawing and media libraries. You know, you can make yourself a little paint app or a media player and have some fun with it. And the best part is, you will be giving me more views if you get your hands on this, because I got a lot of videos explaining various topics on WinForms, like simple elements like buttons and text boxes, and even some fancy ones like designing modern looking UIs. And I even started a new series dedicated to making apps where we will be making better versions of the simple apps we find in our daily Windows PC. Jokes aside, I think WinForms is pretty good for a beginner. Although I said it is deprecated in my other video, I said it because when you become older and understand stuff, you shouldn't be playing with that like a kid. Find something that suits your age, okay? And even since it is offered by Microsoft and you are developing for the Windows operating system, wouldn't that be an ideal choice? And if you want to give this a try, you might need to download Visual Studio Community Edition, which is a free IDE, and I already have a video dedicated to installing the correct workloads and setting up your first project as well, which you can check out by clicking right here. And again, install the Community Edition, because for others you have to pay, and the Community Edition is completely free. Now, there are a lot of other GUI frameworks out there for C++ which are probably better than WinForms and could offer more control over the GUI elements, but to get your hands on those, you need to come to a certain age in your programming career, or I simply won't allow it. You are grounded.
Okay.
So I will start off with the most popular one out there, Qt. Now, Qt is a cool framework. You can make a lot of cool stuff with it. It is also one of the oldest frameworks out there, meaning he's like a grandfather, and hence he does know a lot. Qt is well documented and has a lot of libraries to perform a variety of tasks. They have their own data types even, and hence you might think that you will have to learn all of that all from the beginning. Well, Yeah, you should, but that is not as hard as you think. You know, I say this all the time. Learning new programming languages is not as hard as learning a verbal language. Besides, Qt also provides a drag and drop visual designer and also allows you to build robust native cross-platform applications. So you can design apps and code the logic just like in WinForms. Don't take my word for it. A lot of companies all around the world are using Qt. You know how much of an amazing platform Telegram is, right? Well, the apps are written using Qt. Autodesk Maya uses Qt, which is a 3D animation software. So I think that one is pretty enough to explain how powerful Qt is. Now, the amazing part about Qt is that you can just write one common code and Qt will handle all the hard work and do its magic and compile the same app into different native apps targeting Windows, macOS, Android, and Linux. I mean, isn't that cool? Like, all you have to do is maintain one code base and the apps would look native in each platform. I think that is an amazing feature to have in a GUI framework, because otherwise you will have to write separate native code for each and every platform you are targeting. And man, that is damn hard to do, and maintaining that just creates a huge mess. And that's why a lot of apps you find these days are just based on web frameworks and they don't care about the native look and feel. Anyways, with great stuff comes sad stuff. Qt is not completely free. It is free for open source projects, and if you're using it for commercial projects, you might need to purchase the license. I'm just putting it out here just so you know, or otherwise you will blame me for ruining your career. I mean, if you're a beginner, you will be making open source stuff for the most part, so that won't be that much of a problem. And when you're making commercial apps, the investment is worth it, I would say. And if you're hoping to hop into Qt, you would do so by using their own IDE or integrating it with Visual Studio. Now, wouldn't it be nice if someone gave you a very mature framework with huge documentation and a lot of libraries to work with, and all of that for free? Well, guess what? Someone does. That brings me to wxWidgets, a rather boring looking yet easy to grasp robust GUI framework for C++. I mean, this is Qt without the visual designer stuff, because this has almost everything that Qt can offer you, and wxWidgets gives you all of it for free. wxWidgets is very popular simply because it is open source. On the other hand, it is also a powerful cross-platform GUI toolkit that compiles your code into native applications for Windows, macOS, Linux, and Android, just like Qt. wxWidgets also has its own libraries for various stuff like multimedia, networking, graphics, and much more. Plus, wxWidgets is even more mature than Qt. However, wxWidgets requires a little bit of learning when designing GUI because it lacks the powerful visual designer, but once you get used to it, it is quite powerful than other solutions, I might say. Next, you have Microsoft's very own UWP platform with C++, CX, or WinRT. Just forget all those fancy words. This simply means a way that you can build the best looking apps using C++. With Windows 11, UWP apps got a lot more exciting with modern looking controls, animations, and a lot more. I mean, you saw it all in those videos, and probably a majority of you are using Windows 11, right? The look and feel of those apps are just amazing. And the best part is, you can do it too. Microsoft has nice documentation, project samples, and videos on this as well. All you have to do is install the correct workloads in Visual Studio and hop into a project. The only catch is that you'll be developing apps that run on Windows only, just like in WinForms, because other operating systems do not support UWP. It is just Microsoft's future as they see it. Now, if you're wondering what this UWP is, it is the Universal Windows Platform, which is used in all sorts of Windows-based devices, from PCs to Xbox, HoloLens, and much more. So if you want to get into the fancy Microsoft world, then this would be the ideal choice. Besides, since Windows is the most popular operating system out there, if you can build amazing apps for it, why bother going cross-platform? You can still reach thousands of users just through Windows. I think the sacrifice you are making is worth it when it comes to UWP apps, because this is the future of Windows. And also, you can design UI with the Visual Designer, and you can also design apps that have the translucent look thanks to the acrylic and mica materials. If you want to get into UWP, I will link Microsoft's documentation for now, but I will make a tutorial for that as well in the future, so stay tuned for that. I also want to include Embarcedero's C++ Builder, which is a rapid application development IDE for C++. A lot of developers out there use it, however, I haven't really used it that much, but I know it is pretty cool from what I have done with it. It is essentially just like WinForms, but it is cross-platform and it's pretty straightforward too. It also doesn't have all that nonsense with WinForms where creating the project is just weird in itself. I will not talk about it a lot simply because I don't have much hands-on experience with it. It also has a community edition which is free other than the fully featured IDE, which is a paid software. Anyways, it is a full package of design and development tools to help you build apps ASAP, and it is also very straightforward to use. And next, I'll conclude all other frameworks, since I don't think they are just simple and easy to use compared to the ones I mentioned earlier, because the next few will be very useful in certain specific use cases, and the above ones can be used in developing any kind of application. So there are other frameworks like ImGUI and even graphics and multimedia frameworks like SFML and SDL. But I think these ones are not for beginners. These require a bit of a learning curve and they deal with a lot of low-level stuff as well. And ImGUI is targeted to be used in 3D apps rather than general GUI apps that you will be building as a beginner. SDL and SFML are also similar, although they are targeted to give you access to low-level graphics works like working with pixels and stuff. SFML is useful to use as a multimedia library rather than to be used in general GUI apps. Then there's technologies like WebView. You can use these technologies to use web content inside a native wrapper, meaning that you can embed a simple web browser inside a simple application and use web programming to bring GUI into your preferred native platform. The issues are, you will be not designing native looking controls even though your application is cross-platform. You will not be using C++ for the GUI, which is not that much of an issue really. You will have to have a little bit of web development knowledge, and this method is not very recommended to build efficient apps that require a lot of system resources. If you are using this, you are better off using another language and just dumb C++. But as a beginner, it's fine. You should give it a try, since most apps nowadays are built like this, and even Microsoft Teams is using WebView too. Nevertheless, it is one of the best ways to build modern GUI with all the web capabilities and customize the GUI the way you want it, and do all of this faster than other solutions. The only catch is that you'll be working with an embedded web browser in your application all the time. So I think that's a lot of info to digest. And do you want to know what my recommendations are? Well, before that, you need to give me a huge like and leave a comment about your current programming status. I think the first step should be WinForms, not because I have videos about it, but because it is quite easy to get started. Although it is deprecated and no one really cares about it, it is still a great starting point. After spending some time with WinForms, you can try others too. I would suggest wxWidgets than Qt, simply because it is open source and getting started is straightforward. You can learn a lot of stuff by using it and you sure will fall in love with it. While working with wxWidgets, I suggest you look into WebView too, because it is faster to build apps that way. Then you should definitely look into UWP, because it is a much modern approach to making apps for Windows and there's nothing like it. I mean, you can try it even before using wxWidgets, but I suggested wxWidgets first because you can't always make UWP apps for everything, at least for now. So to not get carried away with the coolness of UWP, first try wxWidgets and get all the knowledge and get a good understanding about how GUI works. And it is also handy because with wxWidgets you can build cross-platform apps, and with UWP you can. Now, it's easier to say than do, right? Well, you can be a programming genius in one day, a week, a month. Learning takes time. Everyone's not a genius. but training and learning can get you there over time. There are a lot of others just like you, so don't be afraid. There's lots of people to help you. I mean, I sure have a lot to learn. I learn a lot through your comments too. I'm no genius at all. If you agree, leave a comment and I can cry in a corner of my room. Also, make sure to check out my videos on WinForms if you are thinking about learning it. I have detailed explanations, tips on making better UI, and even videos on how to make general purpose applications as well. If you enjoyed this video, please give this video a thumbs up and help share this video to everyone else struggling to find a way to get into GUI programming with C++. Also, subscribe and hit the bell icon. It would mean the world to me. And not only that, I can show up in your feed and notifications like a creepy little monster. Thank you guys for watching, and I wish the best for you. Stay safe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye for now.